Hello, Sim fans. Welcome back to the channel. And in this video, we are going to be checking out the new WINWING FCU Unit 1 that is compatible with Microsoft Flight Simulator XP and DCS. Now, in this video, we're going to be going over the unboxing, the included mounting brackets, and how to get it set up for your desk, as well as a software installation and firmware update. So with that being said, let's jump on into it, friends. Okay, let's start by talking about the flight control unit from WINWING first. It is a 1x1 model, and it's a fully structured mold, 3D textured, has a 3D textured surface, as you can see. It has a multi-panel adjustable linked backlight, which is beautiful, friends. It supports automatic game synchronization. Now, it does work out of the box with the default Airbus A320neo V2. It also works with the fly-by-wire and, of course, the Phoenix A319, 320, and 321. I've tested them all. It works with those out of the box. Now, it does not work out of the box with the PMDG aircraft or other default aircraft. However, you can get it to work with Mobi Flight, and there are profiles from flightsim.to to make it work with the default aircraft. But again, out of the box, it does work with the Airbus Phoenix, the fly-by-wire, and default aircraft. That's the A320neo. It also has the same color display with the real aircraft. One of the really cool things, we'll get into a more in-depth review of this thing later on. This video was just about unboxing and the software setup, but I'm going to get into it later on. But it does actually allow you to adjust the brightness in that from within the aircraft, and it actually reflects in real life with the model itself, which is a pretty decent and cool touch. It also has a native glare shield, ensuring the same operating hand positions as the real aircraft. It also has dual mode display drives. It's data driven. It's also stream driven. Data driven display mode is more efficient, suitable for open interface aircraft modules, and it does have add-on modules. Later on, we can talk about that. It does have a stream driven display mode, which can display FCU information of any A320 aircraft from any game running on the Windows platform, synchronizing real time with the aircraft module data, which is a pretty cool thing. Also, as I mentioned before, it has plug and play, and we'll get into it with the application of SimApp, where there's no manual setup required. Okay, so let's go ahead and get on into it with the unboxing of the FCU unit by WINWING. All right, so arrived earlier this week from our good friends over at WINWING, which we're all super excited about. We got the FCU Unit 1, or Flight Control Unit. So I'm just going to do a quick unboxing. I mean, like anything, but it comes fairly well boxed here. A lot of padding, which is a good thing. I already pulled the little cellophane thing that went around the unit off because I was excited to actually finally get to see it. I'm just making sure that you can all see this. Of course, it comes with a USB standard ABN and USB-C, and there. Little Allen wrench and some bolts that comes with it as well. And little rubber feet to hold it on your desk. You can now mount these as well. And show you that here in a minute. So here you can see it comes nicely packaged, cellophane and wrapped. It's got 2 feet, talk about that in a minute, that go on this unit. And let's pull it out of the box. Now I have taken this out just to let you know, again, they had this nice and wrapped. And there it is. As you can see, it has plenty of controls. First and foremost, you can do your AP1, AP2, which would be your autopilot, your head and tracking, or your vertical speed. You also can flip this notch back and forth between 100 and 1,000 feet to control your altitude. Push button and pull out. Metrics, you can change the metrics there, and push to level off and up and down for your metric altitude as well. Your approach button over here, this one's actually left blank. Not sure about that one, but you got your auto throttle button, your localizer for your localizer approach, and then your speeds, your Mach speed, and that over here. So we're going to talk about that here in a minute. On the back of this, you do have SATA. I think that's a SATA connector. So these units, as you build them out, because you can have more than just the first control unit, the flight control unit you see here, but you actually can extend these out and have them locked together and bolt together. You can also use these to mount whatever direction these go. You've got a USB-C, both power and USB-C pass-through, and another display, not display port, I almost said display port, and another SATA interface that could connect units from either side. Let's go ahead and put the feet on. So again, you've got a soft, smooth side here, and then the kind of the molded side here. So obviously, if you're going to put these on the sides, you'll want this to be, I imagine, on the side and line up the holes. So you could actually mount them on the side, or again, you can mount them on the back side. Well, that works like a turn punch bowl. It doesn't want to. Okay. Interesting. Thank God we have the power of editing. Because we're going to need it. That is not going to work. Okay, after fumbling around with this thing, trying to put these, don't try to put these on the back, by the way. I was originally starting to try to put them on the back like this to face them up. These will actually, if you're going to desk mount it, you want to take the one that has the one hole and then the two bottom holes. That one will go on the right side of the FCU and line up those screws to this. And so it's going to actually come up off your desk just a little bit. To sit there, and then you'll put the feet on the bottom. So let's go ahead and do that. You want your shorter. There are two lengths of screws here, hex screws. You want the shorter number five screws. Again, for the right side, you want the one dash or the one slot, two slots, and the nice finished side over here. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. We're gonna take our number five. Oh, we want to have a, make sure you have your nut. I forgot the nut last time. And so just finger tighten that, and now we've got those in, and now we've got it at an angle. There we go. That worked much better. Plus, cue applause. And then I can put these on. But what they have said, I believe, is they want you to plug this directly into USB-C on your motherboard of your computer. Now, a lot of you, like me, I've got at least two or three, probably three USB hubs because I have so many controls. So I'm gonna try plugging this in to the USB hub, see if it works okay, and I'll let y'all know if it works fine that way. I'll also hook it directly into the top of my computer. It's not quite directly in the motherboard, but I've got a port there as well. We'll see how it works, because I'm filled up on my USB ports in the back of my computer directly in the motherboard. So I'll let y'all know if that works. Again, we've got little rubber feet I can add to it, and then also a USB-C to USB-AB cable interface. And that's it, friends. That's all there is to it.
Okay, friends. So the next step you want to do is set up the WinPro software. Now, there isn't anything that's really obvious and blatantly obvious, at least, for needing to do this. There's no instructions that come in the box, and even the instructions or the manual that you download only talks about setting up the brackets and mounting it. It doesn't talk about the software, at least from what I saw scanning it. So you do need to get the WinPro app. And so what you do is just go to winwingsim.com and then go to Download Center, and it's this top app right here. So we're gonna go ahead and download this. And all right, get it Sim app for Windows, click on that, and it is now downloading. Okay, as you can see here, once you have it downloaded, you'll have the latest version. It might be different than what I have here, 1.15.20. It will be in your downloads directory, and so we'll go ahead and run this as administrator. You might get this Windows protected your PC, go more info, and can say run anyway. And make sure if you have a little SimAppPro, it'll do your UAC for Windows. You can say only for me. Anyone uses a computer, I'll just say for me. We'll go ahead and let it, well, actually, I'm going to change this to G. Go to my PC, G, and we'll call this SimAppPro. We'll just do G SimAppPro. So we're going to say G SimAppPro. Install. All right, then once finished, you can hit finish. And now we have no devices here. Why? Because we haven't connected the device. So we'll go ahead and connect the device.
Okay, I should have captured this as well, but I thought I'd go ahead and grab my phone. And so we now, it says, you want to install the firmware. I did go ahead and connect it. As you can see there, it all lit up as soon as I connected it. What you want to do is connect it back here. There are two ports, and you want to connect it in that left one, which says USB. The one on the right is just for power only. But as soon as I popped that, connected it in, and I've got the SimAppPro app, which you can see here. As soon as I plugged it in, the lights came on, and now it says there is a device firmware update. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. It's best to use original USB interface of the motherboard. All right, update. Arrays must be unplugged when updating. USB must also be unplugged. Only keep the device that need to be updated and a mouse and keyboard in. Existing device is 1 of 3 WINWING, okay. Other devices must be unplugged when updating USB. It must also be unplugged. Only keep the device that need update and mouse and keyboard, okay. Okay, now it's, okay, it just went off. And so there it is. Okay, so once you say update, you actually have to go in and hit manually update. So that's important to know. I do have it plugged in. It says plug directly into your motherboard. I have it actually plugged in at the top there. It's a pass through to the motherboard, which goes directly to the motherboard. So we'll say that's good. Important thing to note though, when you're doing the firmware update, it does warn you about only have the device you want to update, because that's if you have other WINWING devices. I don't think you have to worry if you have other USB devices plugged in that aren't WINWING. But devices that are WINWING, you wanna go ahead and unplug those and only have the one you wanna update. You can see here it says it's updating the WINWING FCU 320, which is the one we have here. And as that's updating, of course it's off. And hopefully once that is done, CRC check passed, upgrade successful, and it just came back on. So there we have it. So that is updating the firmware for your WINWING FCU and for connecting it to your computer. So we will do, so here we can do a test. So test, I think if I do, yeah, here we go. So there, if I'm doing the left button here, you can see it's actually showing as I do that run through. And if I push and pull, it's registering that. Then I'm gonna do the head tracking, and that seems to be working. It also shows it here as you're using it. That's cool. Localizer button. So this is like the fancy way of doing control panel within Windows, apparently. So everything looks to be working. Pull, push, push and pull. Now, if you pull it, I'll talk about this more, but you're gonna have to hold on to it because otherwise it'll just move that because I don't have it actually bolted on my desktop here. That's okay. But all seems to be working. Does say plug and play. It should come right out of the box, as you can see here. These are all working.
Okay, that's it for now, SimFan. So that is the unboxing, the software setup, the firmware update, and background on this magnificent WINWING Flight Control Unit 1. And hopefully you'll go and check it out. It's linked below. Right now, you can actually pick it up, friends, for $99.95 US. It's available for pre-ordering. It's normally $139.85. So essentially, you get $40 off if you purchase it now. I will be checking it out in a future live stream, and actually several live streams, with the various Airbus aircraft by various manufacturers. And also watch for a video where I will be doing a review of not only the FCU, but tied along with the flight stick from WINWING. So do watch for that, friends. And until next time, stay safe, take care, and of course, friends, blue skies. We'll see you all soon.